you know, there's a little acronym that someone made out of the word guidance. And it goes like this: God, you and I dance. You know, we should enjoy God in our lives. He is the joy of my life, praise God. And we should walk every day with him, acknowledging his presence, being sensitive to his presence, and resting in him, and just have a good time with God. I want to encourage you, have a good time with God. Don't let religion make you miserable, praise God. That's not what God's all about. That's not what the Holy Word of God is all about. It's to make you free, praise God, to enjoy his blessing. And, you know, he brings you out of things for your own benefit. He doesn't leave you in your sin. He delivers you from your sin, praise God. And he sets the captives free, praise God. He's going to change your thinking today. He's going to give you an optimism that comes from him, a power of his word operating in your life, in Jesus' name. Psalm 37, verse 23, the steps of a good man or woman are ordered by the Lord, and he delighteth in his way. In other words, enjoy your path. He delights in his way. He enjoys the path. Praise God. I love that scripture. The steps of a good man or woman are ordered by the Lord. You know, I looked up that word good, and one of the meanings is valiant. We need to have courage. We need to be valiant in order to be guided by the Lord, because otherwise we'll be ruled by fear, you see. And for God to guide you, you have to be valiant. You have to be strong and courageous. And the only way you can do that is to meditate on God's word. As you can see in Joshua chapter 1, verse 8, he said, don't let the word of God depart out of your mouth, but meditate therein day and night, that you may observe to do all that is written therein. Then the Lord will make your way prosperous. Then you'll have good success. And then he said, be strong and courageous, because I am with you. God is with you. And so you need to acknowledge his word and meditate his word and take it deeply into your heart, and then you'll have courage to go forward. Psalm 46, verse 10, be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth. It's a good word. Be still. You know, just have peace. You say, well, you don't know what's going on in my life. You don't know the problems that I have, you know. But I tell you what, he's talking to people here that are going through difficulties. That's exactly what the psalm's about. He says, just be quiet. I'll be exalted. I'll bring you through. You know, my way is the best way. Put your trust in me. Roll your cares upon me, and I will bless you. Just say, thank you, Lord. I'll be still. Just say, mind, be quiet in Jesus' name. I trust in the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise God. I like this. I'm having a good time here, enjoying these scriptures, enjoying God's peace. Psalm 119, verse 165, great peace have them which love thy law, and nothing shall offend them. Just fall in love with God's word, enjoy it, and you'll have great peace. Psalm 128, verse 1 and 2. Blessed is everyone that feareth the Lord, that walketh in his ways, for thou shalt eat the labor of thine hands. Happy shalt thou be, and it shall be well with thee. You're going to be happy when you reverence the Lord and put him first place in your life. Hallelujah. There's a lot of power in that. Psalm 144, verse 15. Happy is that people whose God is the Lord. That's a great scripture. Hallelujah. And Psalm 145, verse 9. The Lord is good to all, and his tender mercies are over all his works. Maybe you've heard that little phrase, you know, you're a real piece of work. Well, you're a piece of work. You're the Lord's piece of work. You're his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, praise God. And the Lord is good to all. You know, think about the goodness of the Lord, how he sent his only son to die for you. You know, I think about in Romans 8, it says, "He that spared not his own son, but offered him up for us all, how shall he not also with him freely give us all things?" And God will give you everything you need. He'll give you peace and contentment and victory and a purpose and a plan for your life. Satan, I just come against you in the name of Jesus. You lying devil, I break your power. And I loose this one into the will of God, into the truth of God's word. And I pull down the strongholds that said their life is nothing and not important. I break that stronghold in Jesus' name. And I loose the will of God. And I loose the word to do its work today. In Jesus' precious name. Amen. All right, well, let's move on to Proverbs now. Proverbs 3, verses 13 through 18. Happy is the man or woman that findeth wisdom, and the man that getteth understanding, for the merchandise of it is better than the merchandise of silver, and the gain thereof than fine gold. She is more precious than rubies, and all the things that thou canst desire are not to be compared with her. Or unto her. Length of days is in her right hand, and in her left hand riches and honor. Her ways are ways of pleasantness, and all her paths are peace. She's a tree of life to them that lay hold upon her, and happy is everyone that retaineth her. That's God's wisdom that you receive from His Word. It'll bless your life. It's, you know, just seek it above all things and seek understanding. And it said, her ways are ways of pleasantness, and all her paths are peace. God will lead you in the way of peace, not only, you know, in your natural life and the paths that you walk in your natural life, but the paths that you walk in your thinking. These are the paths that lead us down to dark places or lead us into the richness of God. And so as you absorb God's wisdom from His Word, and you just esteem it highly and place it first place in your life and let it be your guide. It'll lead you in your thinking to bright places. Hallelujah. Places of glory where the glory of God is revealed in your life. Proverbs 15:15, all the days of the afflicted are evil, but he that has a merry heart has a continual feast. I love that. A continual feast. Praise God. It's like you're having a good time every day. You might be working hard. You might be going through some tremendous challenges. But hey, life's a feast when you get on the right path.